Hello everyone. In today's class, we will discuss about the laws of Boolean algebra. These laws help us to minimize the Boolean expressions and provide us the optimum solution out of the redundant one. As a user, we have to memorize these laws so that we can implement or apply these laws while minimizing those equations. These are the laws which help us to minimize the equations. The first one is the law of identity, which shows that A is equals to A and A bar is equals to A bar, which means that we can write 0 is equals to 0 and 1 is equals to 1. There is no change in this 0 and 1. Next is the commutative law. Commutative law says that A into B is equals to B into A, which means 0 into 1 is equals to 1 into 0. The answer will be same. We can write it in this form without affecting the output of the system. Next is the associative law, that we can write A into B into C in this form. The multiplication output remains same. There is nothing with the output of the system. Next is really important law, that is the idempotent law, which says that A into A is equals to A, which means 0 into 0 is equals to 0. Fine. That means A into A is equals to A, and same is A plus A is equals to A. We can't write 2A or A square. We have to write A plus A is equals to simple A, and A into A is equals to A, and we can prove it. 1 plus 1 is 1. We can't say that is 2, 1 or 1 square and all. Fine. So 1 plus 1 is 1 and 0 into 0 is 0 and 1 into 1 is again 1. Next is the double negative law. Double negative law says that if I am writing A double complement is equals to A, then I can cancel these two bars. One bar cancels with the another and I can write A is equals to A. Means if I am taking 0 double bar, then it is equivalent to 0. I can prove it also. If you just make a complement of 0 bar, that is 1. Simple 1 bar is again pending. One bar is 0. So answer is same, 0 into 0. So we can directly cancel these two bars if we are having it in our expression. Next is complementary law. Complementary law says that A into A is equals to 0, which means if I am having the value of A is equal to 0 into 0 bar is equals to 0. How? 0 into 0 bar is equals to 1. 0 into 1 is equal to 0. Because as we know, the, you know, AND gate. AND gate gives the output when both the inputs are 1 only. Next, in the case of this A plus A bar is equals to 1. If you are taking the value of A is equal to 0, then 0 plus 1 is equals to 1. As OR gate says that 0 plus 1 is 1. So we can take any kind of example, then answer remains same in this way. Next is the law of intersection, that is A into 1 is equals to A. You can write, for example, if you are taking 0 into 1, then answer is 0, which means this is the A and this is A. Whatsoever the value taken by you, then that remains the output. For example, if you are taking the value of A is equal to 1, then 1 into 1 is 1. Means if you are taking A is equal to 0, then answer is 0. If you are taking 1, then A is 1. Same happens here. A into 0 is 0. Law of union is really important, and it is applicable to most of the equation, that A plus 1 is equal to 1. Which means if you are taking A is equal to 0, then answer is 1. If you are taking A is equal to 1, then answer is 1. So it is proved. Next is A plus 0 is A. You can again put a value of the A. If you are taking it to 0, 0 plus 0 is 0. If you are taking 1, 1 plus 0 is equal to 1. So the basic funda to learn these laws is to put the values and then learn them, rather than being cramming them like A plus 1 is 1. You can put the value. If I am taking A is equal to 0, then what will be the answer? So do in that way. So next is the De Morgan theorem. We've already covered in the previous video that A into B whole bar is equals to A bar plus B bar, which means when we break the bar, then it changes the operator, that is the sign operator. Fine. Next is the distributive law, which means A into B plus C. I can write in simple way A into B and A into C. Answer remains same, because ultimately A multiplied with the B and A again multiplied with the C. Next is A plus BC, which means we can separately plus then that a plus b into a plus c. When we put the value, answer remains same. In this case, left hand side and the right hand side. Law of absorption is really important, so see it very carefully. That is a into a plus b is equivalent to a. How it comes? Multiply it. A into a is a, as we have seen here. A into a is equivalent to a plus ab. Fine. Now take a common. Answer is 1 plus b. 1 plus b is something. See here, 1 plus b. Like this, yeah. 1 plus b is equivalent to 1. So I can put 1 over here. Then a multiplied by a. Then again it is equivalent to left hand side is equals to right hand side. So in this way we put these laws into the equation and we prove them. Next is a plus ab. So see here, this side. If I am having a plus ab is equivalent to a. So prove it. So multiply it, a plus a and a plus b. Fine. A plus a is again a. I can't write 2a because I have told you that a plus a is equivalent to a. Now here a plus b. Multiply it, a into a is equals to a plus a into b is ab. Take a common. I am having 1 plus b. 1 plus b is again equals to 1 and answer is equals to a because a into 1 is a. Hence it is proved. Next is a into a bar plus b is equals to ab. How it comes? So let me clear the screen so that you all will understand it very carefully. Okay, so let's start with this. If I am saying that a into a bar plus b is equals to ab, how it comes? Multiply, a into a bar is 0, as I have mentioned here. A into a bar is 0, a into b is plus ab. 0 plus ab is equals to ab is equals to ab. Hence it is proved. Means these are the laws which help us to minimize the things only. Fine. Next is a plus a bar b is equivalent to a plus b. How it comes? Now a plus a bar in one bracket, a plus b another bracket. Now see in the law, a plus a bar is equals to, here it is mentioned that it is equals to 1. So I can write. Fine. So it is equivalent to a plus b is equivalent to a plus b. So in this way we have to understand these laws and accordingly we can implement into our equations. Thank you.